This video tutorial I will explain how to connect to EC2 instance on AWS using PuTTY. First we have to install two softwares. The first one is PuTTY and the second one is PuTTYgen, which is also called PuTTY key generator. Go to this PuTTY for Windows. And here you can find the installer. Click on this. It is downloading. Click on finish. And PuTTY software has been installed successfully. Here you can see. Double click on this. And here you can see the user interface of PuTTY. Next, we have to install PuTTYgen. Go back. And here you can see the installer of PuTTYgen. Click on this. And here you can see the PuTTYgen software is downloaded. And here you can see the user interface of PuTTY key generator. Now I am going to load the existing private key file which we have downloaded when we launched the Amazon EC2 instance. Click on load and select this PEM file. Then click on save private key. And I'm going to give name as user API web service WS. Click on save. And here you can see the PPK file has been generated. And PuTTY will use this PPK file to connect to Amazon EC2 instance. Close this PuTTY key generator. Next, I am going to start the Amazon EC2 instance. Currently, it is stopped. Select the EC2 instance which we want to start. Click on Start Instance. And here you can see it is starting. Current state is pending. Select this. And here you can see we got public IPv4 address. And using this we can connect to this particular EC2 instance. Or we can use the DNS name. And currently it is running. Now I am going to open the PuTTY software. And in session, here we have to provide the host name. And here this particular instance is selected. And here you can see the public IPv4 address. And this is the host name that we have to provide. Copy. Then click on data. And here we have to provide the username. And to get the username, click on connect, and here you can see the username EC2-user. Then expand this SSH, and here you can see the auth, and click on this browse button and select this PPK file which we have generated. Then go to the session, and if you want to name the session and save it for later use, name it AWS, save. Then click on open. And here you can see it is successfully logged into the Amazon EC2 instance. Close this. Again, I am opening the PuTTY software. Click on AWS. Click on load. And this time, instead of IP address, I am going to give DNS name. Click on this. And here you can see public IPv4 DNS name. Copy this. And already the username is given here. And PPK file also we have mentioned here. Click on open. And here you can see it is successfully connected. Close this. One more important thing is, every time you stop the instance, then start the instance, this public IPv4 address will change. So currently the public IPv4 address is 52.23.211.37. Now we will stop the instance and start the instance again. We will see this IP address will be changing. Select this. Stop the instance. Now it is stopped. Now I am going to start the instance. Now it is running. Now if you see, the IPv4 address has been changed. So now if you want to connect to this particular EC2 instance, we have to use this new IPv4 address. Copy this. Paste the IP address. Click on open. And it is connected successfully. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.